Good morning and welcome to Morning Moments. I have had such a diversity of people on Morning Moments. I've had a lot of actors on, and I have an actor on today, but I've never had a wrestler, a professional wrestler. So he's an actor slash professional wrestler. And it's my pleasure to bring from Kentucky, Mike Buka. Welcome.
That was close. Very good. Thanks for having me on today. I don't know, my when the acting credits come out, it's either Bucci. My name is that they pronounce my name 100 different ways. So I don't know if you hear it later on when you see Halloween Heroes, it could be different. So
how do you pronounce it?
Bucci.
Bucci. Yeah. Well, then that's what I should do is announce it the way you announce.
Yeah, that's fine.
Bucci. So,
but thank you for having me. You've come very high regarded. We have several mutual friends who you've interviewed before. They're very complimentary of your work, your interview style. They enjoy doing it. I'm on Christmas break this week. Took the week off from work with my daughter hanging out at home. And I wouldn't get on the computer at 9:30 in the morning for just anybody. Oh, so well, here we are.
I am grateful for that. Thank you so much. Tell me about yourself. Tell me, what do you do and why do you do it?
I, like you alluded to earlier, I am a retired professional wrestler. I was a wrestler for almost 20 years, traveled the world, WWE, ECW, every major company out there, wrestled in 50 countries, all over the US, pay-per-views, action figures, video games, all of it. Retired about a little over 10 years ago, got into a mortgage in the finance world, actually probably 14 years ago, mortgage and finance, and then starting into banking about a decade ago. I operate one of the branches of one of the largest financial institutions here in town in Louisville, in downtown. I love what I do. I serve on several boards and committees throughout town, including Dare to Care, Salvation Army, Dream Factory. Very busy this time of year, busy all the time, but this time of year for sure. And I do some acting too. That's how I got mixed up with JC Films. Good friend of mine, Bobby Lacer. He was the contact, the conduit for it all. He had a project back in the spring, Halloween Heroes. He wrote a role almost specifically for me, I believe. He booked me for it as Rambo, the security guard. And that's on Amazon Prime right now. You can check it out, Halloween Heroes. I did that. We just shot another one, Anything But Christmas. Great film for the holiday season. Check that out too. I love it. It's been great so far. The partnership's been great. They do faith-based films. It's a really powerful company, faith-based. There's not going to see a lot of violence, chicanery, entendres, anything like that. There's none of that. A lot of kids in the movies and just cool people. When we do the premieres for the movies, we always find like a church or somewhere to premiere it at. We just had one in Shelbyville about 2 weeks ago. It was a massive turnout. So it's weird where life takes you, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. And sometimes if you're just willing to do the next thing, it's just amazing what could happen, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, you just never know. I mean, when I was apprehensive at first, and I told Bobby, I've never acted before. But he showed me some of the scripts, and I've done, hundreds of hours of television and radio and whatnot. And he said, this will just be a natural extension of what you've done. And then I met Jason, the director of JC Films, and everybody else behind the scenes. They were all cool. All the people behind the scenes, the grips, the sound guys, the producers, the audio team, just everybody involved in it made it easy and it was cool. So those are the kind of things that I don't mind lending myself to. If it's Bush League or amateur or it's, not a good vibe, I'm in and out. So, but this is I'm here to stay on this one.
Yeah, and it's amazing what happens if sometimes the journey where you're at today is preparing you for tomorrow, and you may not know that at the time, but things that you learn is transferable knowledge from one career or one event to another, and it's just amazing how things go. I tell people I'm not really smart enough to orchestrate what's happened in my life. I'm so glad I step back and say, okay, God, it's all yours.
Yeah. I mean, you're 100% right. I mentor a lot of young wrestlers in the business too. And just, this is also for the entertainment industry, but sometimes what we don't get in monetary compensation, You are building a tool belt that you don't even realize it, whether it's interacting with the public, how to be on a schedule, how to create a personal brand, how to promote that brand, how to have a sense when you're interacting with other people. How are they coming at? I don't want to say like a street sense, but how are they coming at you? What do they want from you? What can you do for them? How do you read a room? Take the temperature of a room when you walk into it. How do you make yourself stand out? How do you become memorable, marketable? I mean, there's nothing. I'd rather be dead than be average. So yeah. For me, I always wanted to be, I'm not 6'10 and 300 pounds. You know, I'm 5'10, about 230, bigger than the average guy in the street, but I'm smaller than the bigger wrestlers. Yeah. But I would always figure out ways to stand out. So all those things I learned from pro wrestling, I transferred into the business world, the way I create my own personal brand in the bank. I've always felt that people bank with me, not necessarily bank with the bank. My relationships that I've created are personal ones. And even in the film industry too, like how do you handle yourself on set? How are you prepared? Improv is, for me, the number one skill that I learned through public speaking and presentation with, especially with WWE, that I never would have had before wrestling. And it gave me ability to flesh out the lines and fill in the little holes that weren't there to turn these characters into my own.
Yeah, boy, that's absolutely wonderful. You have. I want to. Is there any huge lessons that you've learned this year? This has been a troubled year for a lot of people. Any lessons that you learned that you can just pass on to others?
Yeah, for sure, 100%. I just said this to my employees yesterday at the branch. Guys, take a look around. Take a breath. Take a look around. When you look outside and see maybe someone who's down in luck, who's homeless, who's maybe working a street corner, or a veteran who comes in who lost both legs, or someone whose family member just passed away from whether it's COVID or cancer or just whatever it is. I tell my guys, take a look around because you actually have it pretty good. It's nowhere near as bad as you think, because maybe you didn't get an extra 5 cents on a raise, or the place you were going to go to for lunch ran out of chips, or just you had to wait in line at the gas station. Like whatever it is, like I tell my guys, just take a breath. You guys got a pretty good gig. Like, let's just take a look around. It could be a whole lot worse. So
absolutely. What a great word for us. And absolutely. Mike, I want to thank you. I'm going to put down below your credits, not only for your credits to wrestling, but for film. Okay. And so that people can keep an eye on what you've done and what you're doing. But more important than that, I always ask my audience this: when you think of Mike and when you see Mike's name and when you see JC Films and when you watch this interview, take some time and pray for Mike, that God would continue to just give him safety, protection, and put him in the right place at the right time so he could be the greatest impact that he can. And thank you, Mike, for taking time today to share with me today.
Andy, thank you very much. You're a gentleman. Well done. Like I said, thanks for having me on the show. And I do think there's going to be a role for you in one of the JC films coming up next year in 20. I have a feeling.
Well, I'd be willing and available, whatever God has for me. Well, thank you
so much.
There
we go.
All right. Thank you for joining me for Morning Moments. And
all right, buddy.
Keep coming back, folks.